Greetings, fellow citizens. Today we are testing the beautiful Origin 325A. Isn't she a beauty? And we are starting, as always, with one size one missile. Shields front side 71, stern at maximum. One size two missile. Shields front side 59, stern at maximum. And one size three missile on the way. Shields 53 front side, stern at maximum. One size four missile. Shields all around 50. Okay, that's interesting. So the 325A is so short that one size 4 missile aimed at the front hits all 4 shield faces. Two size 4 missiles. Shields all around at 3. The cockpit is red. We are in a damaged state and we lost the right wing again. Now the Gladius has 2 all-stops as well, and Gladius cannot survive 2 size 4 missiles. However, the reason why the 325A survives 2 size 4 missiles has nothing to do with her toughness, but it's because 1 size 4 missile aimed at the front of the 325A hits all 4 shield faces, and all 4 shield faces are soaking up the damage, while 1 size 4 missile aimed at the front of the Gladius only hit front and side shields, and the stern shield face is just chilling. And this looks actually quite interesting. We don't have a lot of cosmetic damage since 3.0, but this looks very nice actually. 3 size 4 missiles, and this should really be a kill. Torpedoes now, 1 size 5 torpedo. Shields all around at 25 and no visible damage on the HUD. The front was flashing, this means the front took damage, but I usually only look for orange or red spots on the HUD. 2 size 5 torpedoes. And as always, just for fun, 1 size 9 torpedo. I don't want to repeat myself over and over, so have those two memes, and I use missiles and torpedoes just as a yardstick. And another ship is done in 3.6, the Origin 325A. Before we start, in my test I use alpha damage only, so ships like the Aurora and Titan with bulwark shields are looking good in my tests. However, depending on what you fight, you might be much better off with shields that have a higher regeneration rate or that are stealthy. And I tested this, link to my videos is in the top right corner. For now, I rank the 325A about on the same level toughness-wise as the Gladius and the Super Hornet. Yes, the 325A can survive 2 size 4 missiles, but this has nothing to do with her being tougher. This is all about her being a little bit shorter, or her hitbox is a little bit shorter. So 1 size 4 missile aimed at the front hits all 4 shield faces, and all 4 shield faces are soaking up the damage, while 1 size 4 missile aimed at the front of the Gladius and Super Hornet only hits front and side shields, and stern shield does nothing for soaking up the damage. And this is a concept CIG should look into. It doesn't make much sense. And when we are looking at gunfire, there wouldn't be a difference toughness wise between 325A and Gladius. And this was very different in the past. In 2.6.3, one size one missile hits all four shield faces, including Freelancer, and only with the Constellation Andromeda we had the first ship where only front and side shields were hit. I really think, CRG, you should look into this. This looks gamey to me. Let's take a look at a comparison of data of the 325A from 2.6.3 to today, and between 3.5 and 3.6 she got 1.36 times as many shield HPs, but missile and torpedo damage was buffed as well. Size 1 missiles 92 and now 71, size 2 missiles 85 and now 59, size 3 missiles 75 and now 53. In 3.5 she was destroyed by 4 size 4 missiles, now she is destroyed by 3 size 4 missiles. In 3.5 she could survive 2 size 5 torpedoes, now she is killed by 2. And she is and most likely always will be destroyed by 1 size 9 torpedo. Would I go into battle in a 325A? Yes, I would. I mean, she is quite agile, she has good firepower, and you get some added benefits like a locker and a kitchen corner and a bed. Now, if CRG would use real-world physics, this wouldn't make sense. You wouldn't want to have a fighter with a bed and with a kitchen corner, because all those things add mass. This means you would be a lot more sluggish, but luckily or unluckily, however you want to think about it, CRG is using CRG physics, so mass doesn't matter. And right now the 325A is a very nice fighter. And she looks very beautiful. My rating for the 325A in 3.6 is a 7 out of 10, which is a good rating in my book. For me, 5 out of 10 is average, and 7 out of 10 is clearly well above average. As always, you can find a link to my spreadsheet and to my Locus wonderful data in the description below. I hope you had fun watching this video and see you next time. Bye!
No.
Hi, I'm Mark Hamill, though starring in Wing Commander, I'm also featured on Mask of the Phantom.
Wow.
Now this can be yours for
Oh, troublemaker.
Yeah. Look at that. Look at that top.
Look at that. That's
real plastic, too. That is. See, you open. What you do is you open it.
Towards Billy Butler.
You open it. And then you smell the plastic. Oh, that was a good week. Very good week.
Hey, if you got those plastic champagne glasses we asked for.
Oh, dear me.
There you go, Tom.
That's very kind of you. You didn't have to do that. This would be just fine. The way I drink.
Oh, Cliff.
Hey, don't start with me, Bernard.
Thank you. That's very nice. Man, if you people weren't in costume.
Chris isn't.
I decided to put this at the end of my toughness test videos from now on. If you already know this, then just skip it. So how tough is your ship? There are different factors, and I start with the hard factors. How many shield hit points does the shield generator provide? What armor does the ship have? Right now all ships only have some generic armor values. And how many hit points do different parts of your ship have? Then we have soft factors. How big is your ship? How many shield faces are hit by an attack? And how easily are certain parts of your ship getting destroyed? For instance, some ships are prone to losing wing guns or wings. And then we have bugs. Right now we have a bug that the shields don't cover the whole shape of the ship, especially when the shape is elongated.